Hello friends, in this video we are discussing about manufacturing process of rocks. Rocks are the basic material in the manufacturing industry. Now we'll see what is the manufacturing process of rocks. As we know, in the nature, rocks are available in mountains or hilly regions from which we have to blast them, we have to go for mining, after which we have to grind them in the required desired size and shape. So the actual process of manufacturing of rocks include four stages. As we can see, the first step is quarrying. After quarrying, we have to go for mining, and mining is done only for the aggregates. Because as we know, we require aggregates on a construction site, and aggregates are of smaller sizes. So for especially for aggregates, we go for mining purpose. After mining, next is surface finish and dressing, because quarrying and mining will result in the rough surfaces and irregular shape of aggregates or stones. But the stone or aggregate we are used for construction purposes are of required size and shape. So we have to go for surface finishing and dressing. And the last step is preservative treatments, because we have to store these stones for the future use. So we have to go for some preventive treatments. So in this video, we'll see the process of manufacturing in detail, starting with the first, which is quarrying. Now, in quarrying, the process of extracting stones from the natural bedrock is known as stone quarrying. From the naturally occurring bedrocks, we have to extract stones, and this process is known as quarrying. Now, what are the different methods of quarrying? It is depending upon the rock and purpose for which it is to be used. So quarrying can be done by using different methods. So it will be wholly depend upon the purpose and the rock type on which it has to be used. Then commonly two methods are used for quarrying. Now which are these two methods? First is quarrying by hand tools, and second, quarrying by channeling machine. So commonly two methods are used for quarrying. First is quarrying by hand tool, and second is quarrying by channeling machine, and third is quarrying by blasting. So as we see, three methods we can use, out of which first is hand tools, quarrying by using hand tools, in which first operation is digging or excavation, after which heating is there and wedging is there. So these are the three methods which are useful in hand tools. Talking about the digging or excavation, as we know, the traditional tools we are using for digging or excavation by hand. The stones are merely extracted with the help of suitable instruments, such as your pick saws, then hammers, shovel or chisels, etc. This method is used for extraction of soft stones. As we know, by using hand, we can extract the stones which are in soft soils or soft strata. So these are generally used for soft strata. Then by heating, the top surface of the rock is heated. This is done by placing wood or your fuel heap and setting up fire for some hours. So in this method, what we do, we go for setting up the heat over the surface of the rock, and because of which unequal expansion will take place. Because of it, what will happen? Expansion of rock take place and it will be uneven. The upper layer tends to break and separate out. automatically the upper air will tend to break and separate out, and because of which the underneath level will be available for extraction. And then the next hand tool method is by wedging. If the rock surface contains crack or features, the steel wedges or points are driven through it. If the rock surface is already broke or having a cracks or loose, we can simply use the steel pointers which will be driven through it. The rock blocks are then shifted and removed by suitable instruments. This can be done by driving steel wedges into furrows or driving artificial line of holes or the swelling hard wooden pegs. So which can be done by using any of these methods. Over here, as we can see, these are some examples of your querying by using hand tools. This is also the example of querying. Now moving on to the next method of querying, which is querying by channeling machine. So in this, we use different types of machines for the querying purpose. The channeling machine are either driven by compressed air, steam, electric or diesel, which are used to make vertical or oblique grooves or channels through the rocks. So what it will do, if it is a complete rock, it will form a groove or channels through the rocks by using compressed air, steam, electric or diesel. The grooves are of following sizes. Now there are different sizes also. The width of grooves are 50 to 75 mm. The width will be 50 to 75 mm. The depth are up to 4 meter. Then the length are up to 24 meter. Then the length will be up to 24 meter. And the horizontal holes are driven beneath the rock block and wedges are driven to separate the rock block from this bed. Then what they do? This is your depth. If you talk about the depth will be 4 meter, its width will be 50-75 meter, length will be 24 meter. Then what we'll do? We'll have to driven the horizontal holes, and these holes can be driven by using wedges or the log blocks, and then we separate the rock from his bed. Over here, as you can see, we use such type of different instruments and we make such type of grooves or channels, after which we drew the wedges through it and we cut down the rock from the bed of your earth. So these are the different types of instruments we have to use for this purpose. Next, we'll be talking about the querying by blasting. When the rock is very hard and is unfused, then querying is done by blasting. Blasting is the process of losing the hard and closely packed material with the help of explosive materials. Now, various explosives which are used for blasting purpose are, first is your, we can use gunpowder or black powder. Then we use dynamites. Then we use cordite detonator. Then we use some fuses. And but mostly two explosives are used, which are gunpowder and dynamite. So generally, if you go in the quarrying field for blasting purpose, we use the gunpowder and dynamite. In many movies also we have seen the querying, how they blast the rocks. When the rock are very hard, we have to go for mining purpose. Now there are four main operations are involved in blasting. We can't directly go and put the mine over there and blast it. For this we have to go step by step. First is boring hole in the rock. The blast holes of appropriate diameter and depth are made with jumpers. So we have to make the hole in your rock surface with desired diameter and depth. Then charging with the explosives. Now this holes we have to charge with using explosives. That can be a gunpowder or dynamite. Then the fuse wire, or we can say the fuse cord, should be projecting outwards. Next is tamping. Now the blast holes are filled up with damper clay and rammed hard with tamping rods, over which we fill the soil and we have to tamp it very hard so that it should be loosened. If the explosives are loose, they will come out at the blasting. So we have to cover the explosives with clay and tamp very hard. And last is firing. The charge placed inside the hole is either fired with matchstick or electric spark. We can use the matchstick or we can use the electric spark for charging the fuse under your explosive. These are some examples or the pictures of mining or quarrying, you can say. So over here, as you can see, there are big holes, and in that hole we have to fill with blast, which are the explosives, and then we have to tap that explosives, and then we have to charge them. So these are some examples of quarrying or mining. Now next come mining. We talk about quarrying. Now next stage, second stage is mining, and mining is done for aggregates. The rocks quarried from the ores are broken into small fine pieces of size 0.75 to 40 mm, because generally the aggregates used on site are varying from 0.75 mm to 40 mm. So after quarrying, we'll go for mining if the stones or the rocks are used as aggregate. This process is done for aggregates and limestone used for manufacturing process of cements also. Now after mining, the third step will be your dressing of stones. Now the stones after being quarried are cut into suitable sizes with suitable surfaces. This process is known as surface dressing. After quarrying, it will be on huge size. Now we have to cut the stones at desired sizes and we have to dress them accordingly. It is done by the following purpose. First, to get desired appearance from stone. Stone should give you desired appearance. Then, to make transport and quarry economical. Now we have to transfer the stones from one land or their starting point to the end users. So it will be easier if we cut the stone into required block and dress them and then transfer it to the users. Then it's to suit machinery requirements. As we know, we use stone machinery or brick machinery. So if you are using stone machinery, the stones are of desired size. So we have to cut them or dress them properly so that there will be a proper bond between two stones. And for better aesthetical look. All these are going for the aesthetical look, so we should get a better aesthetical look also. Now what are the various types of surface finishes we give to your walk? Then these are the common types of surface finishes, as you can see, booster, chisel rod or circular, drag, furrowed, rebel machinery we generally use, then molded, hammer dress machinery we use, plain finish, continuing, next is polish finish, then punch finish, then we have reticulated finish, vermiculated finish, tooled finish. These are some various finishes. Over here, as you can see, these images are self-explanatory. Boosted, we can see we have given the cross lines at regular intervals. Then boosted and margin. So we fix the margin and then we give the booster. This will all give you very good aesthetical look. So this or dressing is done for aesthetic look generally. Then comb or drag, hammer dress, you can see hammer dress generally has uneven surfaces. Then you can see the chisel drafting here. Then we have some plain draft, as you can see, and then some we have reticulated surfaces. So it depends upon the use of your stone and the requirement of the end users. Accordingly, we have to go for the dressing of the stones. The decay. Now, what happened next is preservative treatment. We have to go for preservative treatments because after the dressing of stones, we store stones for the future use. So there are the chances of the decay of building stones of interior quality to some extent is prevented by properly preservation. So an ideal preservative layer should have following properties. So we have to apply some layer onto it. So which are the layer we should apply? It should have this following properties. First, not allow moisture to penetrate. If the moisture comes in contact with your stone, then it will deteriorate or decay it. Next, not develop projectionable color. The color of the stone should not get changed. Then it should be economical also. The surface chemical which we will be using, it should be economical. It should be so hard to resist the effects of various atmospheric conditions like excessive heat, then rain, sun, wind. So we should resist them. No corrosive and harmless. It should not be corrosive in and it should not be harmful to your stones. Then it remains effective for long time. And last is easy for applications. So these are all properties should be there for the preservative which will be applied over your stones. So in this video we have seen what is stone and what is the manufacturing process of stone, how quarrying is done by using different methods, what is mining, what are the different types of dressing of stones, and what preventive layers we should apply over the stones. Thank you.